Hey there, I'm Maria, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the HTTP 416 error. If you are running into the HTTP 416 error, don't panic. The good news is that you can take steps to resolve it. In this video, I'll explain the HTTP 416 status code and some common causes of the error. Then I'll explain how to troubleshoot and fix the issue. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what causes the HTTP 416 error? There are a few different reasons that this error can happen. For instance, you'll see HTTP 416 if the server doesn't have the specific resource you're asking for. Alternatively, the server could be temporarily down or unavailable. Typically, the document or page doesn't contain the indicated request ranges. Alternatively, the value of the range header, the part that the server should return, doesn't make sense. For instance, let's say you have an image 1,000 bytes in size. If your server specifies the wrong value, such as 1,500, then the browser will send a request for 1,500 bytes from the server. Your server may return an HTTP 416 error in this scenario because the image is only 1,000 bytes. It's also possible that the server is configured to only serve certain types of resources. If you see the HTTP 416 error, it may mean that the resource you're trying to access isn't one of the server-supported types. Finally, you might see the HTTP 416 error if you've made too many requests in a short period. When this happens, your internet protocol or IP address may be temporarily blocked. When faced with the 416 response message, you'll likely want to determine which part of the range is unsatisfactory. This message usually will include a content range that will indicate this information. For example, it may look like the following. Now that we understand more about the HTTP status error and some common causes, let's discuss how you can resolve it. The first thing you should do when trying to resolve the HTTP 416 error is to clear your browser cache. The process for doing this will depend on the browser you're using. For example, if you're using Google Chrome, you can click on the three vertical dots in the top right-hand corner of the screen, then select More Tools, then Clear Browsing Data. Make sure there is a checked box next to Cached Images and Files, then click on Clear Data. Once you've cleared your cache, refresh the browser. Then revisit the page to see whether the error message is still present. It's also a good idea to double-check the URL you're trying to access to ensure that it's spelled correctly without spaces or characters. Another step you can take to resolve the HTTP 416 error is to check the error log. If you have an Apache server, you can access its log by using Secure Shell Access, or SSH, and running the following command. Once you have the error log opened, you can search for 416. Finding it can help you further narrow down which page resulted in the status code. Then, you can take the troubleshooting process further from there. Furthermore, APM tools can help you locate and resolve the HTTP 416 error. These tools can monitor the performance of your website and applications to gain deeper insights and understanding of issues as they arise. For instance, at Kinsta, we use Nginx and Kinsta APM for all of your plan tiers. Along with Dev Kinsta, this APM-free tool is accessible directly from your My Kinsta dashboard. It enables you to diagnose performance issues and quickly identify their sources. At this point, if you're still seeing the HTTP 416 error, the best solution may be to disable range requesting. This will tell browsers they can't use the range request header to request byte ranges from files. To disable range requesting, you can add the following code to the top of your htaccess file. When you're done, save your file, then refresh your browser to reassess the web page resulting in the HTTP 416 status error code. If this still hasn't fixed the problem, we recommend reaching out to your hosting provider for further assistance. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.